I wasn't really a happy kid, so like, I didn't really like going to school and stuff. It just wasn't a good place or a nice environment for me to be in.
Jason Reed, when I first met him, I was scared of him.
Never really seen myself as a cowboy, never really thought about it.
He does so much, not only for me and my business and what we've got going here, but for all the kids as well. He gives so much of himself. And as you see him out there, he's a role model to them all. They all want to be Jason Reed.
Hello, this is The Point. Later tonight we'll meet Jason and the lads from Ward River and see what a difference justice reinvestment can make in a young man's life. The Indigenous Rangers Cadetship Program was established in 2012 as a way to retain students in some form of study inspired by poor attendance from Indigenous students. In the East Kimberley, a small property just outside Kununurra, the products of this program aren't just turning their lives around, but reconnecting to a trade their elders helped create as Kimberley stockmen and women. Craig Quartermaine has a story.
The East Kimberley has a history of wealth built on the back of the cattle industry and the stockmen and women who worked the land for the wealthy landowners who exploited them as free labour. When these cattle workers challenged for fairer work and pay, they were kicked off the station en masse, starting a cycle of displacement and disadvantage that still resonates today. Because of this, the two cultures are forever linked, and it's that connection that is helping wayward teenagers in Kununurra get their futures back on the right path.
Because the chaff and stuff is a bit dry and the copper as well, we just want to wet it down so it's a lot easier eating for the horses and don't choke on it and stuff.
A lot of these youngsters have been disengaged for a long time, so it's given them somewhere to go where they feel safe and happy, and slowly bring them back into listening to instructions and you know, being placed on time and being proud of what they're doing, getting a full day's work in and not being able to walk away. I mean, we're only 8 kilometres from town, but it's still a long way to walk back home.
Come on, get the hose ready. Never really seen myself as a cowboy, never really thought about it.
Jason Reed, when I first met him, I was scared of him. If we go back about 5 years and I was doing relief teaching in the school, and this young man walked in and he scared me. And he would only have been about year 8 age then, I think.
Get the ball!
Jason Reed's like blood to me. I'd give my left leg for Jason. He does so much, not only for me and my business and what we've got going here, but for all the kids as well. He gives so much of himself. And as you see him out there, he's a role model to them all. They all want to be Jason Reed.
Here on Boab Park, Yeehaw Trail Rides runs their diversionary program in conjunction with Kununurra District High School, where kids who struggled in school get a second chance to take up where their forebearers left off.
Well, I wasn't really a happy kid, so like, I didn't really like going to school and stuff. Didn't really enjoy going to school, and I had a lot of problems with teachers and stuff, and it just wasn't a good place or a nice environment for me to be in.
Jason supervises and now mentors other students after 2 years in the program.
Well, when I first came a part of the program, I probably just come back from Perth. Wasn't doing too good in school. So, I wasn't really attending school. So the program came up and, I sort of got edged into it. And I slowly worked my way into the program. And I didn't like it at first, so it was a bit of a challenge trying to get into it.
But from the first day he came here, we've had one upset since then where we had an argument, and he came back the next day and he gave me a hug and he said, "Chris, I'm sorry."
At home was pretty hard because mum and stuff were always drinking and dad was always drunk, hardly home and stuff.
Was it a case of you maybe spent more time out of home on the street or just hanging with friends rather than actually being at home?
Yeah, getting into the teenage years, I'd start going out a lot, wasn't really at home. wouldn't come back until late and stuff, yeah.
It's this background that most of the young men and women in the program share. Mickey Cox from Broome and Blaine Gerard is from Kununurra.
Were teachers helpful or were they...
They were helpful.
Or were they kind of straight away, no, he's a bad kid?
No, they were helpful. It's just me. I was just not all just, what do you call it? I just didn't like to listen to anybody. Yes, I didn't like to be told what to do, but yes, now I'm getting older a bit, start to realize you have to listen.
Well, I was just hanging around with lots of buddies of mine in town and wasn't really enjoying it at school. So yeah, I was just on the street a lot and doing a lot of bad stuff like smoking and stealing and stuff like that. So one day I was wandering around at the Nullywood end there, and a cousin, brother of mine, Jason Reed, he came down there looking for another brother of mine, and he was having a chat to me about what I was doing with myself this year, about sometime last year at the starting. And I wasn't really into the cowboy stuff, but when I saw the boys who was out here, I felt comfortable being around the boys.
But this is a classroom that these troubled students apply themselves under the watchful eye of Chris Thomas and his partner, Cherie Leveridge.
I can't stay and sit for a long time and concentrate. It gets to me. Yeah, out here we got stuff to do, keep our mind occupated, and yeah, it's a lot better.
I get really excited when I think about the program, because I just see the difference that it's making in these young boys and girls' lives. And it's something so precious and exciting, and every day is different.
Cherie is a master horse rider herself, and her family have worked the land along the Ord River since the 60s. She taught her partner Chris how to ride, and now they both teach the young students the skills to become full-time stockmen and women.
Well, interestingly enough, I was one of the original streetwalkers. As a 15, 16-year-old young person, living out the farm here and wanting desperately to have something to do and something to do with my friends when it was a bit cooler instead of being hot during the middle of the day, it wasn't anything that we were doing wrong. And I think there's a lot of young people on the streets that aren't actually doing things wrong, that are simply socialising, getting away from issues that might be happening at their homes.
Mikey wasn't a non-attender. Blaine hadn't attended, I think, for a couple of years prior to coming with us. Mikey had been attempted to go to mainstream, but he was a challenging student then, shall we say. It was very difficult to engage him in anything at all. He worked for me at a school camp last week, and we discussed talking about it then, and he was saying how 12 months ago he didn't know how to listen to instructions. And someone was talking to him to give instructions, he used to switch off. And now because he loves what he's doing, his passion that he's got for what he's doing, he knows how to listen. He's learned how to listen because he wants to get better at what he's doing.
It's the guidance and tutelage of Chris and Cherie that has put some of the students in prime position to take on major job opportunities available as either stockmen or rangers within the Kimberley area. After their daily ride, the group returns to the homestead where the riders and the horses cool off. When watching the kids and their horses in the dam, some things become blatantly obvious. The horsemanship, for one, but the leadership and growth of a young man who has graduated from troubled youth to trail guide and leader. Later on, I visited Jason at his home and saw firsthand how the program had helped this young man, who had such a hard life growing up, but now was able to take on the responsibility for others, not just on the property.
Well, that's the little man, that's Tremaine. That's my oldest boy, and yeah, he's my pride and joy. It was all I needed. It just teaches you how to care more as well, and like, yeah, it's really taught me how to take on people and look after them as well as myself, really.
Since starting the program, Jason has become a father and, along with his lovely partner, look after their two children. His younger brothers also live with them.
I look at my little brothers and like think, yeah, like they need someone to look up to and someone to take care of them as well. I didn't really see myself being the man I am today. It just changes you when you know that he's growing up, he's coming to be a man like you, so you got to be a pretty good man about it.
An honest day's work is its own reward, they say, but coming home to a life you've created for yourself out of nothing is just that little bit more special.
To come in and see my two boys, see my missus and stuff, I'm just over the world that I get to see that every day.